last time, June. She is a yearling, and over the last 7 to 8 months, I have been working on this just, I don't know, a handful of times. And when I've done it, I started with just one cross tie, and then I would work on the other side and switch back and forth. And then the last couple of times, just for a couple of minutes, I'll put both cross ties on and work with her a little bit. So today I'm gonna do that same thing. I like to just kind of start where we were, make sure that goes good, and then we'll do both cross ties, and then eventually she should be used to it and I will be able to just come in and put both cross ties on. But we're not there yet. I've just been doing it very gradually so we don't have any bad experiences. Okay, it is very warm for a September day. June is very quiet today, and I think she's got a winter, her winter coat's already coming in, and I think she's a little overheated. So yesterday was a cooler day and she was really ramped up, and then today we're having this heat and she's just very quiet. So I hope she's not feeling well. I honestly think it's the heat. So we're gonna work on our cross tying. And I'm gonna start with just one and rooming. So let me find my hairbrush. There it is. All right, Junie babe. And we're gonna start with the other side. It's maybe a good day to work on this. She did get a little upset, was calling out. I went out back on the trail with Fina and left her alone. And she was, hey, I don't know. Let's not do that. Let's not do that. That's not okay. I don't know, maybe she's not feeling good. A little agitation with her foot there. And we're just gonna try the normal routine. Like I said, she did get upset when I went out back on the trail with Fina and I left her alone, but she just called out a little, wasn't too bad. So I'm gonna do that, and then take this off and ask her to step over. Good girl. What the pawing behavior is about, but I'm just going to ask her not to do that. So sometimes you have to be a little stern. Brush your hair over on this side. Girl. It's a hot day, huh? Pretend I'm the cross tie over here. So she's being pretty good. Go ahead and put the cross tie on this side and work on her tail. Good girl. Keep this rope just in case I need to get to her quickly. She's going to let it drop. Alright, so I'm going to work on her tail. Getting to this point today. Some of it is she's really quiet. A little agitation because she was pawing, but overall she's pretty quiet today. So that's all I'm gonna do on that. We're gonna start the curry. I'm gonna keep her in the cross ties. Because this has been 7 to 8 months to get to this point. And at any time if she seems upset, I will go back to just one. Or take both off if necessary. So we're gonna curry her. Good girl. That's a good girl. It's hot today. Little baby girl. Okay. Unfortunately, I used to do round bills, but now we do square. Round in the winter, we had more horses, but we only have two, so I'm doing two that need their diet. There was one that needs your diet monitor, so I'm doing square bales, and I don't really have storage, so they're in my, in the barn and kind of in the way, but I'll just work around them. Done, I might put her in the standing stall in front of the fan. Right now my second standing stall is full of hay, so I only have one. Nina's in there cooling out after her workout, after her ride, and maybe I'll put her out and put June in the standing stall. I think she's feeling the heat a little bit. Likes when I do her little bottom. She moves her tail over for me. Thank you. Get the inside of that angles a little dirty. I'm gonna get my other. This one is good for the top stuff. What a good baby girl. Let's do a soft face brush. Here's my face brush. Okay. How are you feeling the heat today? Oh. I hope that's all that's wrong. It is really warm and you have a very thick coat. At least it's coming in. And I'm gonna pick out her feet, and then I'm gonna switch out the horses and put Fina. I'll put her in the standing stall and put Fina out. She's usually pretty good about picking her feet up. This is the first time I've done it with her in both cross ties, so this is really good progress. Let's do your back. You want to do your other front foot first? Good girl. Can we do this one?
She picked it up.
Something might be bothering her. She's usually a little better about picking up her feet. She's being a little resistant, but she's been really good in the cross time. And we're gonna keep going. I'm just gonna give her other 2 feet and then we'll be done.
Here's where I almost got in trouble. June started kicking her foot, kicked it right out of my hand. So for safety, I quickly moved to the front, asked her to step to the side. I made a quick decision that she did not need the cross tie removed. I thought about it, but I thought she was okay. So I went back and then asked her to pick up her foot nicely, held it there for a second so that we could end on a good note for picking up her feet.
That's it, girl. I don't want to leave her in these untied. So, I don't want to leave her cross-eyed while I put Fina out. So, I am going to. If she is grumpy, it must be the heat. I am going to. Okay, girl. But overall, you were good. A little grumpy with your feet picking up. And then the cross-eyed. But we didn't have any major blow-ups where I thought I needed to take the cross ties off while doing that, but I think this heat is making her a little irritable. Okay, so I am going to just put her outside for a second and then switch her and Fina out. Okay. Good girl. Okay, I have June in the standing stall with hay and her soaked alfalfa cubes that she gets twice a day with her stomach supplements. I don't know if you followed earlier videos of her. She had an issue with some chronic diarrhea and I have to have her on stomach supplements for that. And she gets soaked alfalfa cubes. She doesn't tolerate grain, so that's the additional nutrition that she gets, and then she has a multivitamin that I put in that as well. It's just easier for her to digest in a wet meal, and then of course she has constant access to either hay or pasture. And anyway, it's really hot today and she does seem a little subdued, so I decided to let her stand in front of the fan. She does usually like it in here. Knock on wood, I don't jinx things, but she just seems to be overheated a little bit, so I thought she might like to have her alfalfa dinner in the stall in front of the pan. I'm gonna go out and pick the pasture. I do that every day, and then I'll put her back out when I'm done. I don't leave her in the standing stall for long, but I do have her trained to stand in the standing stalls, and she's been doing well with that, and she can stand in here for over an hour at a time. And always I have food and water available for them in the standing stalls. So it's a pleasant place to hang out, and this is something I also did gradually with her to train her for the standing stall. In the beginning, I actually just let her hang out in the barn, and there was hay in the other standing stall, and Dina was in her standing stall, and then June would just would go stand in the other one without being tied. So she essentially taught herself to be in the standing stall. So, okay, I'm going to go clean the pasture, and so that is it for June today. Success. She did really well in the cross ties, so I'm feeling better about that. I wouldn't say we're 100% confirmed in that task, but we're close. I will continue to do what I did today. Any signs of her becoming agitated, I will take them off, because we don't want to have any bad experiences.